Well, let's take a large look at the Pacific right now, because as you mentioned, we do have Hurricane Norman, we have Hurricane Olivia, which strengthened today, and there's another area of thunderstorms that could generate into a tropical system. It has about an 80% chance of becoming a system. If it does, it would pick up the next name on the list, which is Paul. All right, let's dive right into Norman. Norman is kind of behaving the way we expected Norman to, moving away from the islands, moving to the northwest. Most of the rain, the winds, all that is far off to the northeast of the islands, although it has generated a swell for the east shores, and we'll see about 10 to 15 footers from that swell for the east shores tomorrow. So good news is that as Norman moves away, less chance of it trying to swing or curve to the islands and less impacts. It's really at this point a system that will continue to move away from the islands and not really affect us. Again, here's a track, and we'll be watching for Norman to continue on this track and away from the state over the next 24 to 48 hours. There might not much be left of Norman after 48 hours. And of course, that moisture field that's with it still to the northeast, we might see a few windward showers ramp up, but they're not going to be any kind of flooding issues for the state. All right, off to Olivia. Some news I didn't want to hear today, but it is what it is. Winds are now 130 miles per hour, a Category 4 system, still very far from the islands, over 1,500 miles away. And Olivia expected to cross into the Central Pacific on Saturday while weakening, we hope, and nearest to the islands in the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday time frame. The thing that has changed from the last update is that the latest with the intensity keeps it at a low level hurricane with winds at 75 miles per hour. It was a tropical storm, so that intensity has increased overall for the entire track. And again, some of the forecast models have it very near to the Hawaiian Islands by the Tuesday and especially Wednesday time frame. So it's something that we're going to have to keep watching. Over the next 24 hours, we do expect this cone to expand to cover probably much, or if not all, of the Hawaiian Islands. The track, confidence is high on that. The intensity, confidence is low. So we're probably going to see some fluctuations in intensity over the next several days. We do have strong wind shear right now. Upper level winds, that's our protection. As we go into the weekend and into the early portions of next week, upper level winds will still be there. However, it may weaken slightly. So that might account for the stronger system closer to the state. Of course, the only thing that is constant is the changes in these systems, so we'll keep you posted. Download the KHON2 mobile app, allow for push alerts to be in the know.